Don't brag about taking my side piece. Don't brag about taking my side piece, though. That's my side piece. You don't get laid.
Halos mag-iisang dekada ng binabatikos at pinararatangan na producer ni Paulie Malignaggi ang ating pambansang kamao.
What would you say to those fans that say, oh, Paulie's out to get Manny?
I do have something against him. I think he cheated. I feel like he cheated on the way he up, and I don't like that. I mean, an opponent's life more in danger by putting PEDs in your system.
Ano nga ba ang kanyang mga katibayan at mga basihan para ipatong sa ating pambansang kamao ang ganyang klaseng akusasyon? Kung ang opinion nga natin ang tatanungin, ay masasabi natin na naiinggit lang o nahihibang na ang ungas na yan. Pero kung ang ibang lahi naman, ano naman kaya ang magiging reaksyon at opinion sa kanyang mga pinaparatang?
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Panoorin po natin ang patas at walang bias na opinion ng American boxing vlogger na si ShowBizz The Adult hinggil sa mga paratang ni Malignaggi.
Similar
Manny
thing.
Pacquiao, yeah? Oh. Who is an 8 division world champion, yeah? Mm-hmm. Do you think, yeah, I know you've said it in the past, but do you think at the peak of his career, there was some foul play going on?
Yeah, I've always asserted that, and I, you know, I just think that
he said, yeah. You think there's some foul play going on? Yeah.
I'll give it to you the best way I can. Okay.
Okay.
I started boxing. I never forgot the day I started boxing.
Nice.
By that point, Pacquiao was already almost on the verge of winning his first world title. He was a professional boxer, which means he had his amateur career and all this other stuff. I think by the time I fought my first amateur fight almost a year later, I think he was already a world champion the first time. So I started boxing, Manny Pacquiao was already a world champion.
Yeah.
I started boxing, I fought my amateur career, I learned to box, I fought my entire amateur career, you know, learned, came up the ladder, turned professional, came up and down and up and down the ladder in the professional boxing world as well, had a 16-year boxing career in the professional ranks, and then
16 years.
I went through the entire process.
And retired like a normal human being.
Manny Pacquiao, when I started it, was a world champion. Manny Pacquiao, when I ended it, was a world champion. Manny Pacquiao today is a world champion. are we living in fairy tales? Does this guy not age? Aging is you. Aging is you. Does this guy not age? I don't understand. Like, does he not?
Hold on. Wait. Time out. Hold on, Paulie. Is his argument... Okay, hold on. Wait a minute. Is he saying that is so strange that he must be on some kind of steroids or cheating? First of all, I'm sorry, Paulie. I gotta plug holes through your entire argument, okay? First of all, Paulie said he went through the whole process and retired like a normal human being. Okay, hold on. But not like a normal fighter. They don't retire when they should. They don't go through and retire. Ask Evander Holyfield, okay? Ask Sugar Ray Leonard, all right? Ask these guys. Maybe Marvelous Marvin Hagler, you know, they're very seldomly does someone, Floyd Money Mayweather, does someone just go through and leave? You know, ask George Foreman, all right? George Foreman just plugged a hole through his whole argument. Hold on, first of all, George Foreman, he did some strange stuff. Was George Foreman on steroids? He had two careers. Wait a minute. Because George Foreman took on and defeated Michael Moore, okay? And became champion again. If he want to talk about something strange, and he said that, you know, he wasn't a professional, Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao was a champion already, I think George Foreman was probably a champion before Michael Moore was born. You're smarter than this.
Not age. So I actually was a young man, a teenager.
Uh-huh.
I was maturing into my man body. I was still not even a man yet. I was
uh-huh.
a teenager. I matured. I grew into my man body. I grew up. I fought professionally.
Hold on. Manny Pacquiao was a teenager too.
Actually passed my prime and I ended and I was done. And this guy is still on a championship level. So what, does he not age? Because he was already older than me as it is. And not to love guys being on steroids. They pretend to look the other way, actually.
No, hold on. Wait a second. Bernard Hopkins, Roy Jones, beat Bernard. They were the same age. They're the same age. Bernard Hopkins was champion, doing his thing. Roy Jones Jr. was commentating, watching Bernard Hopkins still, not only was Bernard Hopkins still fighting, he was extremely relevant, pound for pound type of fighter.
Mas may saysay pa nga ang paliwanag ni Showbiz at tama nga din naman siya na kung ang pagbabasihan mo ay edad at sasabihin mong gumagamit ng peds para lumakas na parang isang batang fighter at maging champion muli. Dapat pala ay akusahin din ni Malignaggi sila George Foreman at si Bernard Hopkins na sa edad 45 and 49 ay nakuha pa rin mag-champion. Ngunit saan nga ba talaga nagmumula ang mga paratang ni Malignaggi? May totoong basihan nga ba talaga siya or may pinaghuhugutan lang? Nagsimula ang kanyang mga akusasyon matapos ang kaliwat kanang mapahiya sa mga media dahil sa mga sablay na prediksyon nito sa mga naging laban ni Pacman kay Hatton at kay Miguel Cotto na kapwa niya rin nakalaban at parehong tumalo sa kanya.
Man, Paulie Malignaggi, and I want to know his take on this fight with Cotto and Manny Pacquiao.
I favor Miguel slightly, maybe because I fought him also. Maybe obviously you're gonna say it's not because I fought Miguel that I'm picking Miguel, because this time I'm picking Miguel and not Manny,
not Manny.
You know. So I mean, I respect both guys. I think they're both very solid fighters, very good fighters. I just think I know for a fact, out of the guys I fought, Miguel is the hardest puncher I fought. I know for a fact nobody came close, not even Ricky Hatton. You know. And so at the end of the day, Miguel is a strong guy for a welterweight. Manny is a very good fighter, but he's not a natural welterweight. At a certain point, you have to start understanding there's weight classes here for a reason. You know what I mean? And, you know, I favor, if Manny Pacquiao beats Miguel Cotto, I'm telling you, man, he might be the best fighter. I'm telling you. Because at this point, he's beating Oscar. He's beating Ricky. And I don't think Ricky's as good as people give credit for, even though you're going to say, oh, he killed Paulie. But you know what?
Nah, he didn't kill you. He didn't kill you.
Paulie for 2 years wasn't Paulie. And I mean, I needed to get away from my ex-trainer. Right, unfortunately, right. I realized that a little too late. But regardless of the fact, if Manny Pacquiao beats Miguel Cotto, you have to consider him maybe the best fighter in history, man. Because now he's done it. It means he's done it all.
He beat it against an A-class fighter.
Really, if he's done it all. I mean, this is a welterweight who might be the best welterweight in the world, Miguel Cotto. And legitimately.
Right,
he's definitely
right,
the strongest.
Right,
you know
right,
I mean?
Right.
And he probably should be undefeated. You know, we saw what happened with Antonio Margarito. And, you know, it probably happened in the Cotto fight.
Yeah, yeah.
Dito din nagbago ang kanyang pananaw kay Pacman. Buhat ng talunin at bugbugin nito si Miguel Cotto. Dahil para sa kanya, si Miguel Cotto na ang pinakamalakas na welterweight na nakilala niya.
Strong after losses.
You got in the ring with Miguel Cotto, one of the toughest guys. What was that experience like for you?
That's the best fighter I fought in my career, man. Very hard puncher, intelligent fighter, knows how to get down in the trenches and take you there with him, even if you don't want to go there. So, you know, I give that guy a lot of credit. And
dahil kay Cotto niya lang din naranasan na mabugbog ng gusto. At ito lang din ang nagbigay sa kanya ng kauna-unahan niyang pagkatalo.
Corner of the left eye and Cotto now the combination. Malignaggi fighting with a tremendous purpose here. Malignaggi comes back with a gutty performance.
Ooh.
That's a huge left there.
Yeah, let me just say, he came from Brooklyn, USA.
That's the problem. Stop this.
Now, most of that blood. Now, Cotto.
Now the fight starts.
Left from Cotto that landed. Both of them giving it everything right to the final bell.
Hindi siya makapaniwala na ang isang lightweight ay kayang bugbugin at talunin ang mas malakas at mas malaking welterweight. Kaya bukod sa kanyang inggit, ang talagang nakapagbigay sa kanya ng matinding galit at hinanakit ay nang hindi ito napagbigyan na makalaban si Pacman noong 2010.
I was close a couple of times. When I beat Juan Diaz in Chicago in the rematch in 2009, I remember around Christmas time was fielding calls from both sides, and neither side knew. What I'm saying both sides is Top Rank was calling about the Pacquiao fight after I beat Juan Diaz in the 2009 main event. In the end, none of them worked out. In the end, and Joshua Clady got the Pacquiao fight. Because I think Top Rank had just signed Joshua Clady.
na sana ay makapagbibigay sa kanya ng karagdagang exposure at makapagbibigay din sana sa kanya ng pinakamalaking kikitain niya sa pagboboxing.
Manny Pacquiao, when I started it, was a world champion. Manny Pacquiao, when I ended it, was a world champion. Manny Pacquiao today is a world champion. Are we living in fairy tales? Does this guy not age? Aging is you. Does this guy not age? Manny Pacquiao today is a world champion.
Hindi kaya siya ang tumitira ng katol.
Lipad ako to eng.
Kung bakit hindi niya matanggap ang mga imposibleng nagagawa ni Pacman na hindi niya kayang abutin. At hanggang ngayon ay namamayagpag pa rin si Pacman. Isa nga lang ba itong matinding inggit o galit? Ano po sa palagay niyo, mga ka-boxing fans? Comment down your opinion, mga tol. Maraming salamat po sa mga bago nag-subscribe sa ating channel. At shout out kila AMBition.ph, General Magnanaw, Jinskis CPTV at kay Lyrance PH. At shoutout din kila Eliazar, Pops, June Vlogs. At sa mga gustong magpa-promote at magpa-shoutout, comment down lang po. And again, marami pong salamat.